After a late week sell-off last week to the pound, we saw a huge overnight rally, taking the pound all the way up to 134.5, although it was cut short with the fact that there was no Brexit deal. A lot of that hope and optimism that was priced into today's trade went by the wayside as we saw the pound come off as no deal was made. And that's going to be critical. What we're seeing here are much wider trading ranges over the last several weeks, implying that real volatility is very high. So we're seeing these big price swings in the pound, obviously reflective of the uncertainty with Brexit, and we are nearing the deadline. Obviously, that comes on December 31st, and we still have no trade agreements or permanent trade agreements in place, and that will continue to hang over the head of the pound and the euro, for that matter, as we head into the next few weeks. But a big rally cut short, given the fact that there was no resolution made today. And looking over at the Bank of England, they meet this week. And what will they do, given what we're seeing with the Brexit uncertainty? Well, they've obviously been very clear about this. They don't want to do anything until there's resolution. So whether it's a deal or a no deal, they will likely wait to make any changes to their asset purchases or their rates until after the Brexit deal goes through or doesn't go through at the end of the year. So look for the Bank of England to likely be busy in the first part of 2021 if there is a no-deal Brexit that we get by the end of the year or don't get by the end of the year. And lastly, the best indicator that we continue to see here for the Brexit, whether it goes through deal or no deal, is the pound-euro cross, which traded last week as high as 111, sold off to 108 on Friday, rallying to 110 today, but then backed off those highs as we saw the pound come off late in the session. So obviously, still a lot of work to do there. The pound's still falling a little bit short of expectations here. And if you go back to when the referendum was voted on in June of 2016, we are miles from where the pound euro cross was trading. So I think at this point, you need to see at least a move back up to 112 to 113. That gets you back up to those key 50, 100, and 200-day moving averages. But right now, we are still below those. So on a Monday when things started off very well for the pound, they ended with kind of a downer, even though we were still up on the day, given the fact that there remains no resolution to this whole Brexit situation and the clock is ticking.